So this is a second platform again related to learning. So we would like to analyze result and answers of H5P. Okay, so let me first tell you, introduce you to H5P. What is H5P? H5P is an independent library. We can call it, it's a library, which is used to create HTML interactive content using browser. So it allows you to create interactive educational content just on the browser. You do not need to download any software, install any software, or depend on any other library. Let me show you some demo so that you get to know H5P. So this is H5P, and it gives you many examples that you can directly use on your platform, whatever platform you are using. So let me show you one very good example. Let us say course presentation. Let me open one more dialog card. Let's open one more, drag the word. Okay. So this is course presentation. So as I mentioned that this is an interactive content. Let me maximize it. So it's like this. This slide is one content. Okay. And because this is course presentation, so many contents that can be created by H5P are combined in one unit. So you can see the slides there. You can go ahead like this. You can see this is one MCQ that further has some other questions, because see, you can see one out of four is here. So this type of MCQs can be created in HTML5, and that is again provided by the H5P plugin. So let's answer this. You will get a very good feedback, so engaging feedback. It's not boring, like true false is not there. It is bringing up the colors, giving you some symbols, also with the sound. Okay, so now you know how much you get. Okay, if you want to show the solution, you can directly see it here. So this is very interactive. Similarly, you can move ahead. See, this is the fill in the blanks. It is again created with the same library. So you can try something. Let us say, you can retry or show solutions. Similarly, you can move ahead. So this is a simple presentation. There is no interactive element in this, but you can create this using H5P. So video can be embedded within the content. Similarly, you can see this is kind of summary where you are selecting correct statements. And you can see this on the same page, I am getting chances. So how many answers? Two wrong answers. And so it is giving me chances. It is again possible with the H5P. And when it's like this, I can see it in a window that what is my score, and I can share it directly on social media. So if you want to create this system, it will take a lot of time. So the system is already there, but it is not useful. Why? Let me tell you. Now you are familiar with H5P. You can create interactive HTML5 content with this. The good thing about H5P is that it is already integrated with Drupal, WordPress, Moodle, and Sunbird. OpenEDX community is working on it. That means we will be able to integrate it with IIT Bombay X in coming years. But there's a bad thing about H5P is that it uses X APIs, okay, to capture user interactivity, but don't store those results. It stores only basic results, the basic results such as start and stop times, scores and maximum scores per user per H5P content. So that means on the particular demonstration, I tried to solve some questions. So my score was 0, okay? But teacher will never know that I didn't solve the last two exercises. Teacher will be able to see that I got 0, that's all. On which exercise? Did I solve everything? Did I watch complete video? It will not be able to know that. Although H5P captures it. Every click is captured by H5P, but it doesn't store it. So we need to find a mechanism to store that result so that a teacher can make more sense of the data and tweak the content according to that data. So why is it important to store the data? These details like correct incorrect ratio of each question, number of wrong trials before answering a particular question correctly, time spent per exercise per student, it will help teachers to identify the problems with the content and give them chance to improve it. So what to do? We have to create a Drupal or Sunbird plugin. We will start with Drupal. If we get time, we will go to Sunbird. I am not choosing Sunbird because Sunbird is still not fixed. The development is still going on. So we will try to make a plugin for Drupal that read and store XAPI data from H5P. So we will store that data into database and then we will send this data to some learning repository to analyze the data. So there are learning repository who handles this data and they analyze it. So analysis mechanism is already there. We do not need to worry about that either. We just need to find a way to capture the student interaction with the H5P element and store it on our server. Then make an arrangement to send this data in a meaningful way to an existing LRS. So what do you need to know? You need to know PHP MySQL because we are going to work with Drupal. Drupal is based on PHP MySQL. So we don't have any other choice in this case. And obviously you need to know JavaScript, HTML and CSS. You do not need to know any graphics library or whatever. You just need to know about some information about XAPI and PHP MySQL. That's all. And I would need 5 people in order to work on this project. This is my email address. You can call me if you have any question, or if you have any question, you can ask me right now. Yes,
so
please.
What's the difference between this Joomla framework and this Drupal framework?
That's a completely different thing. So see, there are many CMSs, okay? WordPress, Joomla, Drupal. 3 CMSs are there, which are very popular. There are many more. So how an organization chooses the CMS, it depends on the functionality, but because most of the CMSs are open source, so we also need to look at the license they are built on, okay? So WordPress gives a license where commercial content is also possible. So that means many plugins are paid, not free. Joomla is based on same library. On Joomla, you can not only sell plugins, but you can also sell complete platform. You can also sell the services and so on. Drupal is completely open source. The license don't allow you to sell anything. So this is why IIT Bombay chooses Drupal. Okay, most of the educational institutes select Drupal. And other thing is that H5P don't provide any plugin for Joomla. So we can't work on that. We have to select Drupal only. Any other question? Thank you very much.